Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the trap series here at BusyWorksBeats.com/trap. Today I'm going to show you how to use the plugins inside of FL Studio to create the trap sound. So let me break down the trap ingredients before we start. We're going to put it together step by step, and I'm going to guide you through every step. So no worries, we're going to have the project files for you in the video description below. Firstly, in trap, we're going to write in a certain key. These are certain notes that we are going to use, and we're going to write in the D minor key. I'll show you how to create that scale. The sound selection is going to be a bell of some sort. We may or may not use brass. It's optional. Some people like brass, some people don't. So it's up to you if you want to add brass elements to it. We're going to use the bell element for a contrast melody. The brass is more for chord structure. We're going to have a piano melody, very classic in trap to use piano melodies. We're going to use some trap drums, and we're going to have an 808 somewhere in here. You know, trap doesn't seem right without the 808. It just doesn't. And then we'll wrap it up. So let's start with some bells. To the plus button here in our channel rack. If you don't know what the channel rack is, click this icon up here. Open up the channel rack. Now let's add a plugin from Image Align's list of plugins. I'm not going to use your typical plugin here. I'm actually going to go sideways on you. And let's do the Fruity Sim Synth. I think it's just called Sim Synth. Here we go. One of these secret weapons. A lot of people were kind of write off because they don't know how to use it. So this is, modeled after a retro style synth. So let's click here. And retro sounds are coming back in style. A lot of vintage sounds. Let's just click on bells. And now we can create. So let me show you the scale. Let's route that to track one in the mixer. If you don't see these to the left, hit Alt on your keyboard plus M to hide or reveal that. If you still don't see it, click the bells and then change your track to one so it routes it to the mixer. Okay, assign. Oh, you know what? I just realized the button says assign free mixer track. I never noticed that. There we go. I just noticed that. Okay, you learn something every day. Well, let's right click, go to piano roll. Let's close out the browser for a second and let's write in D minor. So, without going too complicated with music theory, and if you want to learn music theory, we teach that as well at busyworksbeats.com/music theory. We're going to start at the note D here, and we're going to map out a certain note structure that we're going to stick to. So what I like to do, you know, in general, is grab a note here, turn the velocity down to zero, and then move it somewhere to the right, just as a quick little template to keep your eye focused on the scale. So I'm going to map out the D natural minor scale quickly. And then we'll show you the notes, and you can just copy the notes exactly. One more tip is for your BPM, we're going to be producing what's called halftime. Don't get discouraged if you don't understand what that means. Just turn your tempo to about 130 or 140, or 150 even has a nice trap tempo. We're just using very high tempos because it's easier to do little glitches a lot easier. So that's why we use those tempos without getting too microscopic into the piano roll. Okay, so let me map out the scale here. So we start at D, then we're gonna go up to E here, then we're gonna go to F, okay, then to G, and then we go A. So we have boom, A sharp, and then C, and then back to D. So that's our D natural minor scale. Here's what it sounds like. Wait, excuse me. There we go. I turned my head for a second. That's our minor scale. Sounds really pleasant with the bells, but let me not get caught up in that. So that is our scale here, D natural minor. And what I want to do, okay, so bells are gonna be in a high octave. So what I like to do to the right is keep the scale template. I make sure I start at D and end at D. And all I do here is just hit shift, left click, and pull it down so that the top note is D and the bottom note is D. It doesn't matter if you overlap these notes because they're quiet, they're at zero velocity. I'm gonna pull it up another octave just so we have three octaves of D. And if you wanna go even further, pull it down for four octaves so you can have it laid out. And for a tip for FL Studio users, go to Piano Roll Options, go to Helpers, and go to Ghost Channels, because now when I go to a new element, and I go to the piano roll, now those notes, are outlined in gray. Now I can use that as a visual template to keep, you know, everything sorted out. So that's what I like to do. Now let's create the bell part, then we're going to move to the second part. So let's start here. Let's add in a note. Again, we have to turn the velocity back up to where it was. I think the starting velocity is 75. So I'm reading that top left value where it says velocity, 75 up here. And let's start on D because we want the listener to remember what the tonic note is. The tonic note is just the root note of your song. So we want them to know the song is in the key of D minor without getting confused. So usually speaking, we're going to start off on D. Okay, so you can get creative with this. I'm going to start with the bell. We're going to mangle it and do a bunch of things to it when we add gross beat, if you're familiar. So don't get too caught up in the melody here. You just want to get an idea started. Okay, so the rhythm here, you just come up with a rhythm. Do you want to go one, one, two, boom, 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 boom? Or do you want to go one, two, three, four, one, two, three? I mean, it's up to you how you want to do it. I want to throw a twist in here. And it's okay to go by ear. Remember, your brain is telling you the music. The computer is just trying to help you translate it. So it's okay to sit there and be quiet and listen until the tone in your head matches the note. That is completely fine. Then I'm gonna go boom, 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 boom. Then back to D. Now all this is gonna be silenced. Now let me show you something. Let's X out of the piano roll. Let's go to the playlist. And let's you don't have to right click up here anymore, but you can right click up here and go to pattern one and drag that into the playlist. But they've updated FL Studio 12.5 to where the pattern picker is on the left. So all you have to do is left click and drag pattern one into the playlist. Now be sure to take out your scale reference or else it will sound. What I like to do is change my snap to grid to bar mode and just cut out the excess. Let's go back to the playlist now. Now notice I turned it to song mode. That's not highlighted anymore for pattern mode. Now let's hit spacebar to. And I'm gonna turn this down just because we don't need it that loud. And I'm gonna hit shift and left click and pull it over. It looks like a timing issue. I must have put these notes on the wrong spot, which is fine. And I had the wrong note as well. Okay, now let's make that cooler. So I'm going element by element to show you how in-depth trap can be. Let's go to our mixer now, since we've auto-assigned it to the mixer. Let's click inside track one, and let's add Fruity Delay 3, a new plugin with FL Studio 12.5. Now these project files will be in FL Studio 12.5, which is not compatible with backward editions, especially FL 11. You may be able to open it in 12, but again, this plugin comes with 12.5. Let's turn it on ping pong mode for the delay response. And let's turn down the wet level for the output. I'm going to turn up the feedback so it has a nice long effect tail and continues to bounce around. Now I'm going to add Fruity Reverb here. Fruity Reverb 2. Here's the trick. A lot of people have been asking me about ambient, so let me show you how to do it. Just turn your wet level very high and then turn your dry level down or very low. I'm going to turn it completely off. I'm also going to pull the stereo width of the reverb to 100% to the left, which means stereo. If you pull it to the right, that means mono, but we want a nice wide sound, so let's pull it to the left. For the bass, I like to take mine out because it muddies up the reverb. Let's turn up the decay time. And now we have like a very blurry sound, very hard to hear, which is good. Now let's add our magic, which is gross beat. Awesome for trap music. I can't recommend this plugin enough. I don't care which DAW you're in, gross beat is phenomenal. Let's go to gross beat, let's go to presets, and let's go to momentary. And let's go to half speed. Now this is just one preset I like to go to for trap because you hear it so much. Sounds completely different. The only thing is, if you have a very fast melody, it's going to slow it down and it might not pick up on all the notes of your melody. So just keep that in mind when you're using half speed. Another thing you want to check out is reverse. Now this takes a bar to read the audio, so you're not going to hear it right away, but you know, just keep that in mind as well. I really love that because the reverb that we added is now going backwards and it creates this swelling effect. That sounds really cool. And I'll show you how to record that into audio. Now there's a new way to do it, which is just right click and render as an audio clip. But let's just assume you're not using FL 12.5. Let's click here and let's go to Edison. Where's Edison? Edison is your recorder, and I love this plugin tremendously. We're just going to record on play, so it gives us a quicker recording without chopping so much stuff out. And when I go to my playlist, I like to cut out a gap because the song is naturally going to loop back on itself. I don't want Edison to pick up on the looped audio because it's harder to chop, okay? And we don't want any unnecessary clicks and pops. So let's just hit record on play. Make sure you're a play marker's all the way back. I hit stop twice usually, then I hit play. It's gonna take a bar to sound, so remember that. And I like to just make sure all the rest of the audio is out of the way. Now all the extra delays and everything, you don't have to worry about these. So we just have to map out, okay, where is our, a 2-bar length. So we just have to make sure we have 2 bars of audio. I'm gonna show you the quick way. Let's send it to the playlist, or if you want to get specific, you can trim the silence here. So highlight everything, trim out the silence, and then send it to the playlist. That way you don't have to chop in the playlist. Okay, and now we're just going to, you can visually see where it stops. So it's 2 bars right here. And keep in mind the audio is sounding separately from the MIDI. So let's go back to the channel rack. Let's send this to a new track because we don't want the same effects on it. We already have it recorded, so we don't want the same effects. Let's send that to track 2 instead. And let's turn off the MIDI by right-clicking. Let's turn the metronome on so we can line up the audio. So at that point, it was done. So let's grab our slice tool, hold shift, left-click, do a vertical slice. And let's go to the paint tool or draw tool, whichever one. I like the paint tool in the playlist. Let's right click and delete the excess. And now what we can do is just highlight it, hitting control left click and hit control B. As long as you sliced it to the grid, your latch paste will be fine. But if you didn't slice it to the grid, it will latch paste and not be on time. So I would just hit shift left click and drag versus control B. So that's going to give us a vibe. Now you can take it even further. You can go inside the audio clip itself and pitch it down an octave. This is just getting weird and creepy, but let's try it. Now, I don't know where the audio went just now. So let's see. Oh, you know what? It slowed it. Okay, I know what happened. It put it to a certain area of this track. That's very interesting. So we're not going to mess with that because it actually changes where our audio starts. Let's run this through some effects. So it's a really cool sound, but let's run it through. Let's run it through the same effects just to hear what it would sound like double affected. Now, one thing we do need to take off is gross beat, unless, I just had an idea. Whoop, get out of the screen. Unless we go to gross beat, let's X out of Edison, click the drop down, replace it with none to get rid of the plugin. Unless we go to gross beat, go to presets, momentary, and then we go to half speed. Let's hear what that would sound like. So trap is, really unique. Really unique trap is about, thinking about sound 2 steps away. So just hearing the bells, you wouldn't have thought we can get to that level. And that's what mixing is all about, having that end vision. So now we have a really, really creepy sound. Now I'm not sure why it's doubling up in audio volume. And I think, let's see. Since it's kind of like up and down in volume, let's add a fruity compressor. Just to take this even further. Now I know we're going a little advanced here, so you can just follow along. And you're gonna have the project files, so no need to worry. Let's just pull the attack to 0 here, pull our release to about 100 or so. And let's start at 10:1 ratio. And let's just pull down the threshold. What I'm trying to do is make the sound a little more even. decrease the attack. We don't want it to create clicks due to the high ratio. Let's say the beginning. You know, that part is too harsh. You can go in the waveform and create a fade in. We're not going to spend that much time. It's not that necessary. The click is not a flaw. It's a creative tool. So let's just keep that there. Now let's start building out the rest of the track. So now we have the creepy vibe going. Try one more thing here, increase the decay a little bit. And let's pull gross beat before delay and reverb. Let's pull the compressor before the delay and reverb. I'm using my mouse wheel to scroll, so that's gonna give us a different tone. And it's gonna soften out that click that we were getting. Okay, so that's signal processing, a little advanced, but you know, I just wanna show you there's a big difference. We don't hear that click anymore. Let's focus on this piano melody. Now, I found a piano in here that a lot of people don't even know is here. So go to packs, go to instruments, go to keyboard, and go to stage grand or close grand. Either one is really good. Stage grand is going to be an open lid. Close grand, close. Actually, I think this is close. I'm not sure if they meant closed or close. Let's just right click and open them both up. So right click, open a new channel. And let's right click close grand, open a new channel. And I believe these are Steinway samples. I can't recall. They renamed it probably for whatever sake. But let's go to track two. And one thing I want to do is go inside this direct wave instance and take off any reverbs, because we're going to add our own reverbs later. So I'm going to take off any effects inside the plugin. They've updated the plugin as well. For FL12.5, let's close out the browser so we don't get confused. Now again, grab your scale reference from pattern one. We're gonna hit Control C, go to a new pattern, pattern two, hit Control V, and we're just gonna go into piano roll and delete those notes. And now we can craft out a new melody using our scale reference here with the piano. So I just wanna hear what the difference is between stage and close. So let me scoot over to my keyboard, my squeaky chair, and let's see. Okay, so let's play some chords. Cool sound, let's go to the close. Okay, it literally means close. I thought they were trying to say closed. So it's a little bit closer, meaning it feels like it's closer to you via their recording technique and, you know, different techniques. So let's hear what I like better in this song. I like the close, it just gives me a little more volume, so let's just use that. But you have that option. Okay, let's send it to track two. Now what I like to do to think differently than everybody else is add effects before I start playing. So yes, I can start playing, you know, but I want to hear what it sounds like in a big environment. So let's go to track two. Now I want to start getting used to this so it's a habit. So I'm going to click on close grand and click here where it says assign free mixer track, or you can hit Control L as a shortcut if you want to memorize that. I just want to get used to that because it helps a lot more because it names the track as well. Okay, so now that's here. Let's add in a couple effects like Fruity Delay 3. And let's go to Ping Pong Delay. Turn your pan width all the way up, or you know, however wide you like it. I'm going to use a high pass filter on the feedback response and pull the wet level down. Again, if you don't know what that means, no worries. We're just talking music theory, or excuse me, music production talk. Okay, so now we feel the piano with all these effects. It gives us a completely different way of producing. Let's add reverb too. Let's add a nice long decay curvature. Again, I like to take out the bass in my reverb just because it can cause, you know, problems later on. I'm going to put a little pre-delay on it. Just cut out the lows a bit. Now it's... And now I feel what the piano sounds like with that reverb. It gives us a completely different creative space. So now I'm going to improv going up and down the scale. And it influences your rhythm and your melodies as well. So I'm going to improv a melody. Again, I'm just going up and down the D natural minor scale. Okay, let's record. This time I'm going to use my MIDI controller. Let's use the metronome to keep track of time. So here's my, let me show you in the piano roll what I'm playing. And then I'm going to go back and show you anyhow. So we're going D, E, F, A, then A sharp, and then back to F. 1, 2, 3, dun. Or 1, 2, 3, dun. And that's going to create tension. I'll show you what the melody is doing, but E to F creates tension because they're right next to each other. So it creates tension in the ear. So let's just record those melody ideas. I'm also holding my sustain pedal for the piano, which... And then back to the tonic. Okay, so. Completely hit the wrong notes in the higher octave because I didn't really sit there and practice what I was going to play. I meant to hit D to C, but I hit E to D, which is completely fine thanks to MIDI. We can fix that. So here's what I'm playing. The reason these notes look the way they do is because I'm holding my sustain pedal, which is an additional piece for your MIDI controller. Okay, so that's FL Studio elongates the notes visually. It doesn't use an automation thing to show you that you're using sustain. It actually shows you the notes elongated. Now I like to keep my sounds unquantized. You can always, for the trap, it's a very quantized genre. You can always quantize it later if you want. Then when it... Okay, so now I'm going to use a bass that a lot of people... So I said I was going to use 808, so I guess we got to stick to that. But you can use a sub bass like 3X OSC. Let me just show you how to use it. Let's do it in here. That way I can create the rhythm for it. And then we can always swap it out with an 808. Listen to this. Let's click here or hit Control L. Send it to the mixer. There we go. And let's pull it down 2 octaves, 24 semitones. So I'm going to do this in a higher octave so I can hear the bass, and then we can drop it into the lower octaves. The thing about lower octaves when you're producing is that it's so easy to play out of key because you can't really hear the tone difference. So I'm going to go boom, boom, boom. So I'm basically going to play the top line part of that melody and the bass. And I might even, no, if I play it by hand, it's going to record the velocity. But I think it's worth it. So let's record notes and automation, and let's turn on that metronome. Okay, so let's record that. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to give the 808 a little more rhythm so it's not like boom, 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 boom. Now for the bass, we're really going to quantize. So I like to hit Alt Q to quantize, and I have my start time all the way up, sensitivity all the way up. Hit accept. Now I'm going to hit Alt plus L to drag out the note so it fills in all those little gaps after we quantize. Now here's the thing, we need to go to our velocity. If you don't see the bottom velocity, there's a little ellipses at the bottom. Just left click and pull it up. And what we need to do is read the top value here, right in this window. We need to read that value. Let's go here. So where it says velocity, 75%. Grab your mouse and you want to right click. It's hard to get to 75. Let's right click and I missed the note. Let's go back a note. And 75, it's in between 76 and 74. It doesn't want to give me it. Anyway, let's just start at 76. It's being a curmudgeon. Let's drag it out. Let's left click, pull it over until our end velocity says 76. Now you have to make sure that the velocity is changing. You don't want to trick yourself. So now everything is the same velocity. And I'll take control down twice to pull the bass notes down an octave. Now to give this a little more audible hearing, let's click on the triangle waveform. So you can do a sub bass line or you can do an 808. So we're gonna grab an 808, give it a rhythm. We're just gonna chop that up so it has a little more rhythm. Let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's pull up an 808 from 808 Science Drums 2 at BusyWorksBeats.com/808. Let's go to our channel rack. Let's find an 808 that fits the vibe. Let's turn off the bass for a second and let's go to punchy 808s first. Now let's try elongated. Yeah, I think we want 808 groove in here. So let's right click, open that new channel. And all we have to do, these 808s are already tuned. So let's click on the 808, send it to a track by itself. And we're gonna copy the MIDI. Let's hit Control C, go to a new pattern, pattern 4, hit Control V. Now we need to give this rhythm. So let's mute the bass. Let's take it out. Let's just add pattern 4 to the playlist. Now keep in mind this MIDI is very low, so chances are we're gonna have to pull it up an octave. So let's go into a piano roll, hit Control Up. And this 808 actually maybe, let's see, let's right click, go to edit. Go to the marker tab, detect pitch regions. So I stand corrected, this one was not tuned to C. Most of them are, so this one wasn't. So 808s are not all tuned to C because sometimes they give you a lot more character when they're in a different key. So that's a little secret there. But let's tune that to F. Let's pull this down an octave. There we go. Now this also comes with kicks. Now I might quantize the piano because if it doesn't link up with the 808, it sounds like the 808 is flawed, but it's really not the 808. Add a kick in here. That kick chronic. And let's click on the sample. Assign it to a mixer track. Let's go to the wrench tool and turn up that level multiplier. And we're gonna do some crazy things, but you're gonna get these project files anyhow. Now I have to reference my speakers. So I'll do that in a second, but let's just create a pattern for the 808. Let's not work on the kick just yet. Let's go back to pattern 4 and let's use that slice tool to create a rhythm in our 808. So I'm just gonna hit shift, left click. Dum, 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 boom, boom, dum, dum, boom, boom, dum, 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 boom, boom. So now the 808 has a little more bounce. If you want to get really, really particular, we can go to the 808, go to the envelope tab, turn on your volume envelope, turn on your hold parameter or sustain if you're in a different DAW. And now when we cut the notes short, the 808 actually stops. So let's go. So I'm going to do that to create a little more rhythm. Creates a little more variety. Yeah, I'm going to quantize the piano. Also, I want to take out, not sure if that's the piano or that's the bells. Okay, let's go back to the piano really quickly. Go to pattern 2, and I'm going to hit Alt Q to quantize the piano. Reason being is because I want it to match up with the 808 timing, so it has a little more impact. Might be a little too much reverb on the piano, so I'm going to pull it back so it doesn't compete with the bells. You can also add an EQ to the bells to reshape the tones. Let's do that real quick. Lose a little body when I add that. But let's A-B it. Okay, so we're cutting out a lot of the frequencies so that the piano has space so that it can sound bright. With that open, it had a lot of bright frequencies. Okay, let's find some drums. Let's grab our kick. And we're just gonna match the 808 rhythm with the kick. Now again, I probably have to go to our, actually let's not use that kick for now, because those kicks are good for using them by themselves. That's why they're in the 808 Science drums too. They're good by themselves. Layered with an 808 might not be the best idea. So let's go to X drums, let's grab a kick. Let's use kick PC. Let's open that up. Now we have a really good kick that layers with 808s called kick IH. It's awesome. Kick PC is good and kick NK. But let's use kick PC. Let's send that to track. Actually, let's go back. Get used to doing this. Click on the sample. Assign it to a track. That way it names it as well. Let's go to pattern 5 and let's create this rhythm. So let's left click, drag out the sequence. Now, if you want to get kind of lazy, well, not lazy, but save time, go to pattern 4, hit Control C. Let's go to pattern 5, hit Control V. The only thing you have to do here is send it back to middle C or C5 in this case. So let's hit Control Up so they're closer to C5. Grab this, hit Shift Down until you get to C5. This way it has the same rhythm of the 808 without, you know, us having to do it step by step. So you just have to make sure all the notes are back to normal. Now, I'm not referencing my monitor, so there could be clashing going on. Which, that clip, definitely. So I'm going to turn off my mic for a second and just reference the bass. Okay, now we're back. So they work fine together, and that's the most important part. You don't want your kick clashing with your 808 because it can sound really bad in the low end if you don't take care of that early. And there's a lot of tricks to that, but that's beyond the scope of this video. Let's grab a snare from the X drums. Actually, there's one. Let's grab the bounce snare NM. And I want to grab a clap, but it's not in this. So let's go to Fleek. From busyworksbeats.com/fleek. Let's go to drum kits. Let's add clap 4 from Get That. It's a very bright clap. And it really cuts through. So let's add that on the. Now here's what separates regular time from halftime. So let me go to the pattern mode. 1, 2, 3. So we put the snare on the 3 instead of the 2 and the 4. Every time you count the metronome, that's 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4. So we're counting. Every time you count to 3 and 7, that's where you add a snare. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You know, so that's the difference in halftime and regular tempo. Let's go back to the playlist. Now I'm going to go to a new pattern, pattern 7, and I'm going to add in snare variations. Okay, so I don't like to keep my drums all the same because that makes the track feel a little boring. And you want to cut out as many drums as you can along the way. That's in the arrangement phase. We're not that far yet, but so I'm going to add a bouncy snare here. And it just adds a little head bob. Okay, so I'm gonna left click, drag this out, see how far we can go. Looks like we have a max of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, about 16 steps. I'm gonna drag this out, so it's 4 bars. Okay, that way our snare is changing up over time. Just go to our levels in the mixer and start turning stuff down. Usually in trap, your kick and your snare are your loudest, along with your vocal. Let's keep that snare and clap going. I'm gonna label the tracks for you so you don't clap-o. Let's call that clap-o, and let's call this snap-o, and let's call this kick. Let's call this 808. Bell, piano. Okay, there we go. We're gonna color the track, the patterns later, so it looks cooler. Okay, so the track needs something that's like, you know, gonna give it that vibe. So we have the drums. We need a hi-hat. Let's go back to BusyWorks Beats. Let's find a hi-hat. Actually, we can probably find a hi-hat right in PEX. Let's go to either drums or drums by Mode Audio. Let's see what they have in drums. I haven't been here in a while. Hats. Choose to use this one. Open that up. I'm gonna fade it out a little bit. A little shorter. Let's go to... So now let's go to channel rack. I'm gonna pull it in closer so it's not 16 steps. For my hi-hats, I do like change-ups, but I don't want it, you know, that crazy. So. So boom, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, so. So I'm gonna do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, boom, but it. So just like I would be rapping. Huh? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, boom, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Very simple. We didn't even create a hi-hat roll. Only thing you want to watch out for with your hi-hats is that they're not too on the grid. You want to go to your wrench tool. Well, sometimes, or excuse me, I meant to say, make sure they're not too early. Because sometimes when you put them on the grid, they sound extremely early. So go to your wrench tool and turn up time shift. So it's going to delay the hi-hats a little bit off the metronome count. Give you that southern bounce. Now we have that bounce, all because of that hi-hat timing. So at the second half, I don't want it to sound the same, so let's make that unique. So we create a new pattern about it, and let's create that change up. So you want to create as much change as you can without being too crazy. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, so, so let's go to piano roll. I'm going to show you how to create that. Let's go to pattern mode. So you're probably like, how do you do that? You go to snap the grid, go to 1/3 beat, and then you just draw in triplet notes, these are called. And I'm not sure what the velocity is here, but let's assume it's 77 somewhere. And left click and drag it across. So now we have that kind of contrast between quarter timing and triplet. change my snap to grip back to a half step so we don't get confused later. Let's process this 808 a little bit. So a lot of people give up on their beats because they're not fully mixed and it doesn't sound boomy and punchy and hardcore. Mixing is a huge part of music production. That's how, you know, legends like Chris Lord-Alge can go into a studio, record a whole band, and then have it sound completely different at the end. It's because of mixing. So never underestimate mixing and learning mixing. We teach you mixing at busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy. But what I want to show you here is not to give up on your track just because it sounds whatever. So let's go to, let's see here. Let's use ImageLine plugins. Let's go to either Fruity Wave Shaper or Fruity Fast Distort or Fruity Blood Overdrive. I'm going to try each. For Fruity Wave Shaper, I like to click the cog and then pull the mix level down before I start working. Then I right click and I create a little distortion shape. I make sure I pull back the mix level so it's not too aggressive. I can always blend it later. A little too much for this track. So let's use Fruity Fast Distort. Pull back the mix level. I'm gonna pull down the post gain and pull up the pre-gain. I like that distortion. Let's add parametric EQ too. I'm gonna use my monitors as reference for the bass. So let me turn off my microphone so it doesn't feed. So my room's not fully acoustically treated. I don't want to get too heavily in referencing and mixing, but it's important to feel your music as well while you're going. So I took off the effects, and what I think I'm going to do is automate all these. So let me show you an advanced technique for creating different sections in your song without actually doing a lot of music. Let's right click. I'm going to create an automation clip for each of these effects. So I'm right clicking the mix level, creating automation clip. And all these, let's call these Bell Automation 1. And I don't know why it's spaced out automation, but let's copy and paste this so it's easy. Hit Control A, Control C, copy and paste, right click, go to rename, Control V, just type 2, boom, type 3, 4, and 5. Now, usually I put the automation right below the, I put it right below the thing it's automating. Okay, 14. How do we get to 14? That way it's organized. But in this case, there's so many tracks to move. We're just going to, and it takes up a lot of real estate on the screen. So we're just going to keep them at the bottom. Just remember, these are all for the bell. Or you could just move the bell down. That would make sense. There we go. Now we're clipping. So I'm going to turn everything down because I don't want to clip yet. So I don't want to clip yet. So the track's not going to feel its most vibrant, but just remember. I want to try something called the Transient Processor on the kick. An image line plugin to add a little tech to the kick. Just want to see if that adds any oomph. Again, we're clipping. Okay, so I meant to show you the automation, so let's turn these values down to zero. Make sure you snap the grids on bar. It's just a lot easier to work with automation. And you want to right click to add these points. So I'm going to turn it off or at 0% for the beginning. And then in the second half, we're going to have it on at 100%. So all those effects come in. Or you can do it effect by effect. You can get as creative as you want. I'm going to turn them all off up until that point. So that way they don't kick in until the second half. So it creates a switch in the music. I'm gonna experiment here. I was just trying different octaves for the 808. Now you can take out the piano and create a whole different section there. Let's create a whole different section. We have all the elements, the sound elements. Let's find a synth here. Let's go to SimSynth. Again, one of those hidden secrets in FL. Let's go to track 10 and let's create a new kind of section here. So let's insert a track and make sure we are on pattern 10. Grab it, drag it into the playlist. Now I want something really slow, like bing, 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 bing. So now I can get weird. Now let's go through the presets. You can probably skip the bass presets. So this one sounds cool in a high octave, so I'm gonna draw it out. Let's go to the metronome. So boom, 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 boom. Now let me slice out the little tail on each note so we don't have to deal with that. And also the sound has a very, sustained sound. So we need to go here. Now, if you don't know anything about sound design, it's fine. Just make sure you increase your release just a little bit. It gives it more of a bell tone. Now I'm going to go through the presets. I like that one, but let's just see what else there is. Well, that sounded cool. So you can see a lot of names that are from classic synths like Moog, Oberheim. So that's where. That's the brass that you can layer. We probably can, let's see if we layer the brass. That doesn't fit the vibe, it's too bright. So I need something with a little grit to it. So I'm just going to keep going through presets. Here's what I'm looking for right here. Let's just do a higher octave. See a flute. We might create a flute line instead. Let's try that. Yeah, I don't think this section requires an elongated melody. Let's bring in the drums because I know it's hard for you to comprehend what's going on here. Also, make sure you start from the beginning or else your effects are going to sound offbeat. to add an EQ to the kick. Now I'm going to use my monitors again to really get that frequency locked in, but till then, let's boost around 80. So remember that bell's going backwards, so hearing stuff forward. Can't make up my mind for some reason. So I might not add it. That day to wait. See, the hi-hat really adds that bounce. I think we started with the bass. Then. Bass we use, now I'm confused. And if you're ever lost, always beatbox. Or we could just, let's do this. I'll leave that open for you to create. Let's create over the piano. So I'm just going to create a different melody area. I'm going to improv it just to save some time here so we don't waste too much time thinking. Let's record notes on automation. Let me slide back to the keyboard. And let's do just a little accent. Did it record? I hope it recorded. I don't know why pattern 10 is blank when I just recorded. So that is odd. So I've noticed that in a couple songs where the MIDI doesn't show up. I have no idea why. Or whatever. I'll start leveling. If you want to get real crazy, you can automate the channel volume for the bells. All right, so let's start leveling. I'm gonna add a vocal idea in here just to really kind of finish this track for you, give you something to work with. Let's add to my vocals picture. Now it's gonna lag the vocal a little bit, so I'm actually gonna do it. Let me see. Minimum low male, 25 hertz. Fast retune speed, and let's map out the D natural minor scale. So we have C, no C sharp, D. Then we have D, E, F, only sharp we have is A. So let's get rid of all the rest, and then we're not playing B.
Here's the scale, written there, hang nail, hang 12.
So let me just act a fool. Let's record some ideas. And let's see what we get.
Don't wait. I need starting voting and none to say. Okay. Way from Lotus spreading out and down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm okay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. 40 million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 40 20 south to bay. Had the 60 color polar, but all the soul was all about. Recon was all about. T-Core had all the gold. It's more than all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we straight up.
Yeah. So let's hear the vocal. It's a little jagged because I'm hearing myself a little lagged, so I can't really time the vocal too well. So I was mumbling. Let me turn on my thing again. Give me 1 second. So I was mumbling because we can always create lyric for it later. Lyric later. Let's just, you know, mix the vocals a little bit. I'm not saying you do this every single track, okay? So do not do this like it's the save all for every track of yours. It's not.
Okay. Way from Lotus spreading out and down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing bottom.
So now that you have the vocal, now that you know the rapper's pocket, you go back and you figure out how to wrap the beat around the rapper. Like what to turn up. Like the snare needs to be louder.
Okay. Way from Lotus spreading out and down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing bottom balls and now I'm way. 40 million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 40 40 south to bay.
So I'm gonna start mixing here. I'm not gonna go over everything because that's a whole course in itself. We have mixing tutorials that, especially vocal mixing, so go to busyworksbeats.com/vocal mixing. Styles like Drake, Future, Kanye West, everybody, Billboard artist. So let's go here.
Don't wait.
I'm gonna send my vocal to the aux track here.
Don't wait. I need starting voting and nothing to say. Okay. Way from blood is spreading out and down the bay.
So now I'm gonna mix a track again. I can't go over everything about mixing because that will take up way too much time. So I'm going to turn off my mic. We're going to mix. And if you want to learn more about mixing, go to busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy.
Okay. Way from Lotus spreading out and down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm okay. 30 passing bottom balls and now I'm way. 40 million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 40 40 south to bay. Had the 60 color polar, but all the soul was all about. Recon was all about. T-Core had all the gold. It's more than all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we straight up. Yeah. Don't wait. I need starting voting and nothing to say. Okay. Way from Lotus spreading out and down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay.
30 passing modem balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 for this one just out the bay. Had the 60 color polo, but all the soul was all about. Recon was all about. T-Core had all the gold. It's one and all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we sprayed up. I didn't write nothing to say. Okay. Went from dirty, sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 for this one just out the bay. Had to set the color full of blood. All the soul was all about. Recon was all about. T-Core had all the gold. It's one and all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we sprayed up. I didn't write nothing to say. Okay. Went from dirty, sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 for this one just out the I didn't write nothing to say. Okay. Went from dirty, sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 for this one just out the bay. Had the 60 color polo, but all the soul was all about. Recon was all about. T-Core had all the gold. It's one and all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we sprayed up. I didn't write nothing to say. Okay. Went from dirty, sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 for this one just out the bay. Had the 60 color polo, but all the soul was all about. Recon was all about. T-Core had all the gold. It's one and all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we sprayed up. I didn't write nothing to say. Okay. Went from dirty, sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 for this one just out the bay. Had the 60 color polo, but all the soul was all about. Recon was all about. T-Core had all the gold. It's one and all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we sprayed up. I didn't write nothing to say.
Okay. We're from Lotus Ready, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a maid. Oh, wait. Mine is starting running and I'm sick. Starting running and unsick. Okay. We're from dirty, sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, boy, that's the pay. Trying to get me on a blunt, but no way. We're from 30, 40, 40, south of bay. Had the 60 color pull up, but always was all about. Be gone was all about. Tico had all the gold. It's one and all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we sprayed up. Starting running and unsick. Okay. We're from dirty, sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, boy, that's the pay. Trying to get me on a blunt, but no way. We're from 30, 40, 40, south of bay. Had the 60 color pull up, but always was all about. Be gone was all about. Tico had all the gold. It's one and all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we sprayed up. Starting running and unsick. Okay. We're from dirty, sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, boy, that's the pay. Trying to get me on a blunt, but no way. We're from 30, 40, 40, south of bay. Had the 60 color pull up, but always was all about. Be gone was all about. Tico had all the gold. It's more than all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we sprayed up, yeah.
So again, I'm referencing my monitors and my room is not treated, so some of the low end doesn't translate to the headphones, so I would go back and forth and back and forth to just make sure I'm EQing in the right spot to pull up that bass. Okay, so that's how you do it. We did a full track here. Let me label this vocal and we mixed it, we did everything. Oh, you know what I forgot to do is colorize the patterns. So let's, since it's trap, let's do like a bright red and then black. Let me see what black would look like. This is gonna be really weird, but let's just see. It came out pretty cool. Okay, you can still read us as pattern 11. So let's do the same thing for our audio and clips. Bright red and black. All right, we're getting savage on them. So that wraps it up for today. You're gonna get these project files again. If you skipped ahead, go to busyworksbeats.com/trap or go to the video description to get the link to download this project file today. And I might as well play it like two more times just in case you skipped ahead, and then we'll wrap it up.
Oh wait, mine is starting running and unsick. Okay. We're from dirty, sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing modern balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, boy, that's the pay. Trying to get me on a blunt, but no way. We're from 30, 40, 40, south of bay.
At the 60 color polar, all the soul was all about. We gone was all about. Tico had all the gold. It's more than all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we straight up. I didn't write nothing to see. Okay. Went from dirty sweaty, heading down the bay. I ain't had another rest and now I'm gay. 30 passing more than balls and now I'm way. Bought a million in a month, but that's the pay. Tryna get me on a blunt, but no way. Went from 30 for this, what you south to be. Had the 60 color polar bar, all the soul was all about. Be gone was all about. Tico had all the gold, it's more than all the gold. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid on the way, yeah. Now we just paid. If I dare come to say, want my arm out the way, then we straight up.
Alright, go to BusyWorksBeats.com/trap to download these project files for free. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.